Hey folks, alright, I'm back. I'm on leaf. Oh, look at that, magic level 14. Bam. That's cool. So here I am. Last time I hit 45. So I am now going to start on a minor quest run, if I will. I'm looking to do right now, I mean not obviously in one video, because it's going to take a while. I'm looking to do the Postman missions. The Paradox Tower quest. I'm going to start the Marid faction of the Djinn quest. I don't think I'm quite strong enough to finish that yet, but I'm going to start it. I'm also going to try the Mad Mage quest. I'm going to rebuy my blessings, and I'm also aiming for the Blessed Stake. So quite a few things I've got to get myself doing. So, for the most part, I'm not going to do all these, like, one after another. I'm going to try to do them all kind of simultaneously. Which will be an interesting process, I suppose. I'm actually going to go back and check my financial situation back in the depot, because I'm pretty confident I'm going to need more than 30k. So yeah, this is going to be an interesting process, because these quests require, Oh, I got a composite hornbow now. I also want to see... Okay, my offers for coconuts are not there anymore. That's moderately annoying. Because I'm going to need those. Alright. So I've got these pages up on my wiki. Except for where the blessings are, obviously, because I know where the blessings are. I do want to check my money. Alright. I'm a little hesitant about how much money I should be carrying around, just because I am doing a couple of things that are sort of dangerous, and I don't want just all of my cash to be inside of my my inventory, or inside of my backpack, especially when I'm A, going into free territory, and B, don't have my blessings, so I just want to be a little cautious with that. But anyway, alright, so the first thing I'm definitely going to do is go pick up the Blue Djinn quest, because I'm in Anchorman, and I was actually just about to start doing that wrong. I was about to go to the Djinn base. I forgot you have to find, what's his name? Melikor? The blind dude that wanders around. Who's actually a huge pain to find, because he does, in fact, wander around. Convenient, though. Alright. I'm going to say a word of greeting to this guy. Hi. Word of greeting. I'm going to copy that because I don't trust my ability to spell it correctly. I hit Control C there. Okay. Bam. Okay. Well, I'm glad I said that to him. Wandering the streets of Anchorman is a man named Malik. Whatever. I'm about to sneeze. Hold on now. There we go. Talk to him and ask him about the word of greetings. He will tell you that djinns always greet each other with the word jinya. You can now enter either of them. Okay. Well, the wiki doesn't say you have to say it, repeat it to him, but it definitely gave me a quest log update when I repeated it to him. So, I don't know. I would just be safe and repeat it to him. So now we're off to the Blue Djinns. It's currently 412. I want to remind myself of that. In fact, actually. Private chat channel. We'll say I started the video at 410. It's currently 412. We'll say I've been here for, I don't know, 2 minutes. I have myself on ignore. That's great. Alright. And let's do this again. There we go. Let me re-ignore myself now. Yeah, because I'm not doing, like, a specific hunt, and it's probably going to be a little bit more awkward for me to keep track of how long I've been doing this, I'm going to actually try to pay attention to the time a little bit more than I do normally, because I don't want to be, like, 3 hours into this video at some point. So, yeah, it'll all be good. Interesting fact, though, both of my paladins... Sylvius and Leaf are going to be Blue Djinn faction, which I think is interesting. I'll just leave that there, I don't care. Could just eat the mushrooms, but whatever. Probably shouldn't just be wasting my mana. Oh yeah, definitely should not be wasting my mana, because I have the spears. Also, on that note, while I'm auto-walking, I'm pretty sure I set this to a hotkey. Was it Exodicon? F5? What do I normally have on F5? Wait, really? Okay, good. I guess that is. It's weird that I hotkeyed that to my my healing or my mana potion buttons, though. So yeah, I'm kind of looking forward to this a little bit. Kind of looking forward to it, to be honest. Got some good to break things up every now and then. I'm a little bit regrettable, though, that I'm going to be doing like a huge burst of quests and then just immediately go back to a huge burst of tasking, but it's what happens. Alright, so Control V. Alright. Okay. Umar asks you what you're doing here. Say passage. Alright. Yes. If you want to enter a fortress, you have to become one of us and fight the Ifrit. So are you willing to do so? Yes. Are you sure? You pledge loyalty to King Gabel, who is, you know, and you are willing to never ever set foot in Ifrit's territory unless you want to kill them. Yes. Oh, okay. Welcome, then. You may pass. And don't forget to kill some Ifrits now and then. Alright. Now we're going up and we're talking to Boquel. I don't know what that guy's name is actually pronounced as. I don't know if I have to Djinn this dude. Okay, I think I can just use high. Okay. We're asking him for a mission. That was not the mission button. That's the mission button. My collection of recipes is almost complete. There are only but a few that are missing. Now that we talk about it, there's something you could help me with. Are you interested? Yes. Fine. Even though I know so many recipes, I'm looking for the description of some dwarven meals. So you could bring me a cookbook of the dwarven kitchen. I'll reward you well. All right. So we got to get the Kaz to get that. So that's now accomplished. Now we're kind of working on the Postman missions. To get to the Postman dude, I have to kind of go to the Face area. But I also want to pick up the Paradox Tower stuff, which is in, starts in the Plains of Havoc. So, there's also that to consider. I also kind of want to pick up the, alright, we're gonna boat to Face. I'll pick up the first step of the Blessed Wooden Stake stuff. I'll also get the first blessing while I'm in Face. We'll pick up the Postman quest while we walk towards the Plains of Havoc, and then we'll kind of roll from there. I want to see, actually, because I'm pretty sure when you're doing the early boating steps in the Postman quest, they have to be done in an actual order, if I remember correctly. Oops, and I'm walking past the stuff. I, like, map-clicked there. I look forward to being able to kind of fight cool things with Leaf. Because so far I haven't really been able to... Well, I mean, I killed the Hydra. Although I think that was mostly a fluke. I'm not going to continuously attempt to kill Hydras. That's just a bit more. So, first step... is, okay, you do actually need to boat in a certain order, which is moderately annoying. Yeah, it's kind of annoying. It's kind of annoying. Okay, so I guess what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna boat to Face here. Go pick up the Postman stuff. Since I'll be close to the Plains of Havoc, I'll go do that. And then walk back to Face, and then work from there. Also, while we're at it, Paradox Tower... The next step in Paradox Tower is to talk to Zoltan and Edron. So we'll do that as we kind of do it. The Mad Mage quest is all just done in the Mintwall area, so that's not something I need to look into until I'm getting to Mintwall. Djinn quest is currently locked down on getting to Kaz. Alright. And where do I need to go for the Blessed Wooden Stake? Let's take a look at this for now, too. Going to map click my way over to the boat while I'm looking at the wiki. Alright. I'm going to need 5k for that. Plus about, it says 1.1k for travel fees. Alright, yeah, so we'll pick that up by... Okay. Okay. Now, I can't boat directly to face, I know. I like that the gold seller's, like, using the fact that it's a double EXP weekend to, like, promote his gold selling. I'm trying to think of the best way to do this. Probably would have been... I'm actually going to be conservative with my money right now, because I am a little bit concerned. So I'm going to carpet to Svargrond, I think, and then boat to Thace. I think that's the cheapest way to handle this. Might be cheaper to go Edron, but... Yeah, let's just, you know, do the Edron. And it'll be faster to go to Edron. So, Edron, yes. Edron's has not aged well. Which is a shame. Because, like, Edron's kind of cool. It's, like, the first premium city, I believe. So it's, like, kind of a cool layout and everything. But it is a shame that it didn't really age well. But, yeah. So, whatever. Alright, so up we go. Do. And now we're going just face. So, hi, face. How much is it? Can you take me to face? Good. Alright. So, first step is our blessing. Which will be a good first step because it'll allow me to immediately see if I don't have the money to do this. And then on that note, oh yeah, I made an enchanted spear. Oh yeah. So yeah, we're gonna do that. Then we'll pick up the Blessed Wooden Stake, and then we'll go for a walk again. Yeah. So anyway, though, on the note of the, what's the word I'm looking for? Double EXP weekend. I decided to make this video, like, right now, because, you know, I've got work later on tonight. Like I said, it's currently 4:21 in the afternoon. I go to work tonight, which means I won't be back until Friday morning. I'm trying to go to bed, like, soon after I get home now, so that I can kind of be awake at, you know, 4 in the afternoon nowadays. Normally I'd be waking up at like 6 p.m. or something like that, which is not great. So, I'm doing this now because I won't be playing Leaf at all during the double EXP time. I will have him train because, you know, it doesn't really matter. Furthermore, while this video is supposed to kind of be a, like, here's how I would level up my Paladin kind of situation, the fact that I've been playing Leaf for, what, several months now, and have not even at level 50, most people probably would have would have lower skills than I do, because they would not have been spending this amount of time standing at the trainers like I have. But I don't want to get the, like, the training is okay, because that doesn't really affect my, like, speed of doing things, but I do not want to get EXP too fast, because it'll interfere with my tasking. So we're not doing that. Part of me wants to go kill the Banshee, just because, you know, it's cool. But I don't think I have the tools for it. I need a pick for that. Blessing. Right, I have to actually say the word to this guy. Spiritual. Oh, wow. Alright. 5k. That's a little harsh. A little harsh. Yeah, wow. A little harsh. So I'm looking at 25k, wow. Well, I'm going to definitely need to withdraw some of that 40k I have, that's for sure. Yeah, wow. Is that a banana peel? Yeah, we're going to take that. Because those are used in the Postman quests, and those can occasionally be a pain to find. That's another thing that's going to be a little bit of an annoyance here. There's quite a few random items I'm going to need to acquire. I wish I hadn't sold all my coconuts. Alright, though. But, yeah, so... At this point, yeah, we're still on the first step. So I like, this video's been going on for, what now, basically 15 minutes. And so far, out of the 5 quests I'm trying to do, or 6 things I'm trying to do if you consider the blessings also, I've started 2 of them. We're not off to a quick start. And I'm going to the temple for this. I'm freaked out walking past people, especially when one of them is a person that purchased a mount, which makes me think he's got a whole bunch of money and not a whole bunch of skill. I know that's not necessarily like a fair assessment, but it's just the way I assume. Alright, and now what do I say to this dude? Alright, I just say steak to this dude. Steak. Oh, that's a lot of text. Alright. Yeah. I said a steak. A blessed steak to defeat evil spirits. I know an old prayer which is said to grant... I'm not paying attention. Sacred power and be able to bind this power to someone or something. However, this prayer needs the combined energy of 10 priests. Each of them has to say one line of the prayer. I could start with the prayer, but since the next priest has to be in a different location, you probably have to travel a lot. Is the stake really important enough for you to go through that, or are you willing to take this burden? Yes. Alright, I guess you need a stake first. Maybe Gammon can help you. I'm pretty sure Gammon's here. Good. And we're just saying stake to this dude. Making a stake from a chair? Are you insane? I won't waste my chairs on you for free. You have to pay for it, but since I consider your plan blasphemy, it'll cost you 5k. Yeah, thanks, Tibia. Arg, my heart aches. Alright, a promise is a promise. Here, take this wooden stake and now get lost. Alright, so now we're going back to him. Progress slowly being made. Okay. Good to know. Also good to know that the blessed wooden stake actually has to go in order. I can't just put them in whichever, direction I want. So, I have to go to Carlin, and then I have to go to Abdendril, and then I have to go to Khazad-dûm. I'm sorry, Vinor, then Khazad-dûm. Whoops. What does this guy want me to say? Do I have to say steak to him? Yes. That button. There we go. Bam! Are you ready to receive my line of the prayer? Yes. So receive my prayer. Light shall be near and darkness afar. Now bring the steak to Tibra and Carlin Church for the next line of the prayer. I will inform her what to do. I won't be able to technically complete 100% of this Blessed Wooden Stake quite yet, because I need to go to the, last part needs to be given to Chandor, something like that? The shaman dude on the, Marinia Island. So I'd have to do a little bit of access to get to that I'm not really willing to do yet. So yeah, we'll get back to that. It's a pelvis. I'm actually going to pick the pelvis up. I've always wanted a pelvis. Alright, so... Yeah, well, here we are. Here we are. Now I'm kind of getting into the groove of things. Oh, man. I'm kind of tired. Which is annoying, because, it's 4:28 p.m., but I'm kind of tired. Ooh, got a map click again. I like these quests, because I can just kind of do the whole map click, sit here thing. It's just, I'm leaning back. I've got a desk chair that you can recline in, sort of. So I'm just kind of, reclining right now, just watching it. I'll be like wholly unprepared if somebody tries to PK me right now, which will be fantastic, but whatever.
Oh man. So anyway though, yeah, today's I guess Wednesday. This video won't be up for I guess a little while, so you'll miss out on that. But yesterday was Tuesday, which was also Super Tuesday in the United States, where a whole bunch of the like early voting process goes. Donald Trump did well. Hillary Clinton did well. Whee! I was gonna do a one of my FDR videos, but I just didn't feel like it. Plus, I don't know. Nothing major happened. I mean, like, everybody knew Trump was gonna do really well. I mean, I guess a couple of people probably hoped he wasn't going to do really well, but everybody knew he was going to. Alright, let's pick this up here. What do I join, or do I have to talk to the other guy? Yeah, okay, I gotta talk to this guy. Hi, join. Mission? Yes. You're not a member of our guild yet. We have high standards for our members. To raise in our guild is a difficult but rewarding task. Are you interested in joining? I might consider your proposal, but first you have to prove yourself worthy by doing some tasks for us. Are you willing to do that? Yes. Excellent. Your first task will be quite simple, but you should better write my instructions down. Can you read and write? I can, but it's unnecessary because I've got a wiki. So listen, you will check certain tours our members have to take to see if there's some trouble. First travel with Captain Bluebeard's ship to Carlin the Face. Yeah. Uzan to Edoran to the Femur Hills. From the Femur Hills, whatever. Travel with Captain Seashore to the city of Venor. And finally find the Technomancer Brodox and travel with him to the island of Cormea. After this passage, report back to me here. Okay, remember the Tibian mail service puts trust in you. Don't fail and report back soon. Just tell me about your mission. Alright. And now we're off to the Plains of Havoc. Come to think of it, I never did the like level 20 10k quest either. There's actually quite a few quests I haven't done, too. Like, I could if I really wanted to. Do I have a stealth ring on me? I bet I don't have a stealth ring on me. I don't even know why I decided to check that yet. It was for sure I did not have a stealth ring on me. I always like this guild hall. I mean, it's not in a great... Well, it's in an awkward location, I suppose. But I've always liked it. It's one of the ones I was, like, looking into getting before. Bibby Bloodbath is not there. Alright. I'm also thinking that in this, the Plains of Havoc, there's quite a few ghouls and other things. I might be able to get some skulls. I know I need 8 skulls for Paradox Tower. Amongst other things that I gotta pick up at some point. I remember, so fun little story as I walk here. Back when I first started to play, I kind of, like, explored the Plains of Havoc. On my, like, you know, level 12 knight. You know exactly how well this is gonna go, right? My level 12 or something knight. And I came through here, past this guild hall, I think that's called Snake Tower, I wanna say. I don't think it's called Snake Tower. We're gonna find out now. River's Watch, maybe? Something like that? It's a person. She's a paladin. River Spring. Alright, that was kind of close. At least in the second one, not the first one. Snake Tower, I don't know where that one is then. I kind of hugged the waterline when I was doing it. Because there was, like, dead giant spiders, and it was cool, because I know somebody had killed one of the giant spiders and looted a steel helmet and didn't pick it up, so, like, they just left the steel helmet there. And, at that time, like, steel helmets were better than the, like, Legion helmet that I was most likely wearing, so. It was kind of awesome to loot that, and I was like, yeah, awesome! And then, like, the dude came up, and he is pulling the giant spiders from wherever they spawn to, like, up here. I would say I was probably closer to around this area. Still, though, he was pulling the giant spiders, like, pretty far. I mean, like, at the same time, to be fair, back in those days, like, everybody had worse skills, and weapons were also, like, vastly worse. So, I mean, maybe a paladin would actually really need to pull a giant spider that far while running it. I mean, you know, it is what it is. I am not really taking the ideal route right now. Oh, come on. And I hate using spears. Well, anyway, yeah, so he pulled up a giant spider. And then, like, saw what, that I was, like, I guess in his hunting spot, and I don't know. Got in Tibia, like, in standard Tibia mechanics, saw a person, you know, like, 1/8 of his level, and then became furious that I would be anywhere near him. Like, how dare I enter his visual range? So then he lured a giant spider at me, and it killed me. Yay for Tibia. The best, online community you'll ever find. Oh, well, anyway, though, so, yeah. Pretty sure everybody knew Donald Trump was winning. Everybody kind of knew Hillary was winning. If anything, I guess there would be some level of surprise that Ted Cruz picked up any of the states. I think Marco Rubio picked up one. I think. I wish I had a, obsidian knife right now. Yeah, I'm definitely not trying to fight a whole bunch of random monsters on the way. But I don't really go through the Plains of Havoc a lot. And when I do, I'm fast enough and strong enough that all these things are like a joke to me. So I'm not really sure, like, the best way to go through right now. At least I'm not taking damage. Did I say that right as it, like, hit me in the face for a bunch of damage? I really wasn't paying attention. I want my Cyclops toe, though, and my money. Might as well take the food, too. Alright, let's get rid of these rats, just so that they're not in my face. I broke my first spear at some point. I don't know when. Alright, we are now entering the undead area. It does, I have to say, it does freak me out a little bit when I see a large spider creature running towards me. Just because, you know, I know I'm in an area where giant spiders exist, and I'm not sure exactly. I can probably outrun a giant spider, I think, as long as it doesn't haste. Pretty sure I can't really effectively kill a giant spider yet. I'm pretty sure ghouls drop one of the things I need, pretty sure. Really? And I just want my, like, my ranged attacks to hit. Do I need bones? Alright, we're actually gonna check that. Because I don't know if I need bones. I wanna pick it up for now. Alright, let's just... I wonder if this is the first demon skeleton leaf killed. So why am I sticking those? Alright, we're gonna pick up the bone. Because again, I don't know if I need bones. And I kind of wanted to, Oh look, another demon skeleton. Alright. Thank you for hitting him. Miss. Oh wow, and then I've just recently broken two additional spears. Good to know. I probably, yeah, I don't know why I was just, like, letting the demon skeleton stand next to me. I might as well pick up the throwing stars, because I'm kind of still at the point where those are relevant to me. I'm actually going to, now at this point, I'm going to just search for bone. Okay. There was nothing in Paradox Tower about bones. And I'm going to check the Postman question missions. Bone? Okay. I do need 20 bones for the Postman. which is going to be a pain because they seem to weigh a lot. All right. Meanwhile, let me get back to Paradox Tower stuff. I will kill that skeleton while I'm scrolling down to see what I have to say to this guy. Bone. You've been boned. All right. Hi. They want me to say Hugo. Did I spell that right? Nope. Try again. Hugo. Ah, the curse of the Plains of Havoc, the hidden beast, the unbeatable foe. I've been living here for years, and I'm sure that this is only a myth. Myth. Paradox Tower, by the way, is like one of the cooler quests, where it has a bunch of like interesting lore and stuff into it that nobody ever like looks into at all. There are many tales about the fearsome Hugo. It's said that the abnormality accidentally created by Yenny the Gentle. It's half demon, half something else, and people say it's still alive after all these years. Yenny the Gentle. Yenny, known as the Gentle, was one of the most powerful wielders of magic in ancient times. She was known throughout the world for her mercy and kindness. And now I need to go to Edron. Is what it's saying. Alright. So at this point, we are walking back to Thace, to boat to Carlin. We are now taking a break from Paradox Tower a little bit. Alright, I'm not going to kill those things, actually. We're just going to head out now. I like that I haven't cleared a section of the map over here. I just let that stay blank, apparently. It's whatevers. Do-do-do-do-do-do. Blue skidoo, we can too. I bet I'm freaking her out right now, massively. And I feel bad for that, but... I am not going to kill these. Like, I'll block for her. I'll be nice. I'm such a kind person. Is she attacking with Royal Spears? I really can't tell. Also, I'm doing a pretty solid job at blocking these Cyclopses for her. I'm not taking any damage. Go me. Ah. I'm helpful. Alright, yeah. That makes me feel a little bit better for probably freaking her out a little bit by following her. Still, yeah, there you go. Also, I forgot that place is new. That little, like, path. I know I've followed it once or twice and then just, like, promptly got lost. I don't know. Plains of Havoc always seem like a really weird spot to go hunt. Because it doesn't strike me as large enough to go hunt. I mean, it's got the giant spiders, which is great, but I mean, if you're not capable of hunting the giant spiders, it just always seemed... I don't know. Just not sufficient. That's all I can think of. It just seems not sufficient.
So we've been at this for 32 minutes so far, which is a decent amount of time. I'm not sure exactly how far I want to take this. Let's see, my next step is boat to Carlin. After I boat to Carlin, I am... walking to the Femur Hills and carpeting to Edron.
So while we're in Carlin, we're getting the blessing in Carlin. So in Carlin, I'm upgrading my blessed wooden stake. The act of boating to Carlin is putting the postman forward. I'm getting my blessing, and I'm also getting the blessed wooden stake. I think before I walk to the Femur Hills, I'll walk to Abdendril, because they're close to each other. And I'll get the second part of the blessed wooden stake, then I'll walk back to the Femur Hills and carpet to Edron. And then I'll do that part. Yeah, well, I mean, I'm not gonna like definitively say when I'm gonna call the video because you know I'm not sure how long parts of this are gonna take, but it's a little it's a weird juggling game I'm doing. I only need one banana peel. But is that a dirty fur? Awesome. Awesome. I don't know who's throwing these around, but it's amazing. Also, I don't know why I was walking to the postman spot. I know that's not where I need to go. I need to go back to face. The Tibia, like, mass transit system is, like, okay. I like that there's the, like, the boat system, and now they also have, I mean, the steamship's still, like, relatively underutilized. I mean, you can take the steamship from Cormea to Farmine to, Kaz. I mean, I guess it's okay. Like, the only issue I have is, well, I mean, and they also put the carpet in Kaz now, which helps it a little bit. But Kaz is not in a great location. And I've never really enjoyed hunting or just being in Kaz, so there's that. And, like, Cormea is also a pain, because you have to then, like, walk from the steamship to the Cormea boat, to then boat to Cormea. And then there's also a the carpet in Edron, too, so I don't know. But, like, I like the mass transit system, and I like the, I like that there's, like, the three of them. It also sucks, though, that the carpets aren't always in the greatest locations. Like, it's like they intentionally are like, let's just make this process, like, a little bit more annoying. So, like, I get that, you know, there's the carpet in the Femur Hills, which is annoying because it's not just in Carlin. But the carpet in Edron is also, like, slightly annoying to get to from there, from the boat. Like, you have a decent walk to go. Same with the Svargrond one. Like, the carpet and the boat in Svargrond are just so incredibly far away. It's such a pain. And then out of that, where else does the carpet take you? To Durashia. Durashia is the good one. See, we got the three mass transit systems, but the carpet and the steamship are, like, a little bit lacking. But it reminds me of the Elder Scrolls 3 Morrowind. Because I liked, there was no, you know, nowadays it's Skyrim, and before that it was Oblivion. There's, they have, like, the fast travel systems. But I like the fact that there wasn't a fast travel system in Morrowind, and instead you had to use, like, the mass transit. And you had a couple of different kinds of mass transit. A whole bunch of dudes hanging out here. Hi. Carlin. Yes. Yeah, I don't know. You had the like ferry boat systems, so you could like boat from a couple of the towns to the other towns. You had the Mage's Guild teleport system. This is not the one I needed. What? Tibra, west of the depot. What? I was, like, positive that was the temple. So where's Tibra? That's Tibra, okay. Alright, now the next question is, where's the entrance to this building? There we go. That was a little weird. Steak. Yes, I was informed what to do. Are you prepared for my line of the prayer? So receive my prayer. Hope may fill your heart. Doubt shall be banned. Now bring the stake to Meliol in the Elven Settlement for the next line of the prayer. I will inform him what to do. But yeah, so you had that mass transit system. The Mages Guilds had their like series of teleporters that would teleport you to the different Mages Guilds. The main one, though, was the Silt Striders, which were giant fleas. Like, giant, giant fleas. Like, bigger than trucks. Oh, look, Bibby Bloodbath. I am pretty confident I can't handle her. Because it's, what, like, two orc leaders and warlords? Yeah, I don't think I can do that. Alright, wait, no, we're gonna check. Deviation from plans. Man, this is annoying. I'm pretty sure I can use poison walls, is what I'm checking. Bibby. Bloodbath. I want the actual monster statistics. Where's the depot? Alright, there's the depot. Alright, Bibby Bloodpath. I'm pretty sure she'll walk around poison. Okay, she'll walk around poison and energy. That's good to know. Alright, in that case, how much is a poison wall gonna cost me? Poison wall. A 100? Are you joking? Oh, God. Buy two of them. Alright, good. And I'm capable of casting them. Good to know. Alright. Alright, this may or may not be awful. We'll see how this goes. I do not remember what button configuration I use on this. That's kind of annoying. Oh, there we go. I don't know why I thought I used it on a control. Okay. Let's make poor decisions. I'm kind of hoping some of the warlords would go away and not just be standing right there. Yeah, it's cool. Alright, yeah. Alright, this might just kill me. Who knows? I feel like I shouldn't be carrying around all this money. Alright, I'm gonna walk back into town and deposit the money a little bit. Alright, yeah, just we'll play it safe, because I'm not 100% trusting this. Yeah. It's just, you know, that's just the way it is sometimes. I don't know. I don't want to die and drop 20k. Also, let's see, what else do I not want to drop? I definitely do not want to lose the Blessed Wooden Stake. That's for sure. Alright, everything else I can basically afford to lose. And we're going to use the Enchanted Spears for this. Yeah, alright, this is probably like a horrible idea, I'm thinking. we're just gonna go with it. Whatever. It's three, like, orc warlords right there. There we go. Alright, let's let them move. Wow, blocking the one orc warlord into that corner was definitely not what I wanted to have happen. That's, like, the worst thing that could have possibly happened. At least I don't think they heal, right? They're just, like, taking poison damage now. That's good. Yeah, wow, like, he's not gonna make a diagonal step. Well, monsters don't usually make diagonal steps. But yeah, that's, like, really bad, also. Okay. This is a little scary. I'm not really sure I should go do this. I'm still gonna die. I should have bought more poison. Alright, yeah, this is, like, a horrible approach. I gotta remember, I don't have, whatchamacallit. I don't have, better heals. Because every time I went to low HP, I tried to use, like, whatever the super paladin heal spell is. Oh god, alright. Oh god. Oh god. This is going well. Okay, so this is, yeah, this is. Oh, wow. All right. I think I should have bought more poison walls, and I'm in fact going to go get more poison walls now. this is good. I'm doing great right now. I just want to point that out, that I'm doing fantastic right now. It sucks because I have no idea where the mana shop is in this town either. Poison wall. Why do I have a cure poison rune? Poison walls. All right, let's get like not that many of them. That's for sure. Let's get like four of them. All right, and then mana. I can't believe I'm about to. Oh wait, I have mana potions in my box. That's amazing. Where are those at? Oh my god, best thing ever. All right. That's the best thing ever, having a bunch of mana potions. Oh, I forgot to pick up the poison bomb runes. All right, let's try this again. Maybe if I just suck less, my life would be better. All right, let's try this again. Doo-doo. This is like me trying to kill the Hydra, that like really horrible idea that I'm having fun with though. So, I mean, it's all good. And like again, there's gonna be that thing with Tibia where I'm gonna get nothing worthwhile out of it. Like, it's going to objectively be a waste of my time in every conceivable way. Oh god. Oh god. Alright, let's try to kill, like, one Orc Warlord. Yeah, that was me pushing all the wrong buttons right there. I don't know if you guys saw that. I think you probably saw it. It was pretty obvious that I was being an idiot right there. There we go. Alright, let's get rid of the leader. I'm trying to, like, get rid of the easy things, I guess, at this point. And that guy's cheating. Alright, let's, I'm succeeding now. That's the important part. Oh, come on, you suck. I mean, I'm also doing this whole fight in defensive fighting because I think that's safer, but there we go. On that note also, I was unsure how effective like using walls to hunt would be on a PvP world because of the you'll take damage from walking through the things. It's not too bad. All right, let's use some attack magic to kind of speed this up. Oh, what? Oh, she died. Okay. I was like, what just happened? Dark armor, a small amount of money. Awesome. And what else? I thought I killed three warlords and a leader. Where's the dead leader? Yeah, did I not kill an orc leader? Oh, there he is. Okay. Well, I'm pretty sure that was ultimately profitable. Because I got, what, 1k? It was probably not profitable now that I think about it. I suppose if I had picked up that one plate armor, that probably would have made the difference between it being profitable or not. I mean, yeah, okay, so whatever. It was stupid. I'll just leave that there. I had fun, though. That's the important part. Alright, so I guess now is a pretty good time to end the video, I think. Hi, withdrawal. I'm gonna just withdraw some money. And I'm gonna call it a night here. Cause then, I mean, the next step is what? Walking to Abdendril, and then walking back to the Femur Hills. I'm just going to end it up here in Carlin, since I almost never end videos up in Carlin. It'll be fun. So anyway, folks, like, favorite, comment, subscribe, check me out on Patreon, Twitter, Facebook. You won't see any Leaf videos until after this weekend, so I will see you guys for a while. And I think I'm going to go back to using distance fighting. So yeah, alright, I'll see you guys.